Hi friends, this is Varsha Kakkar here. Before starting this stability studies requirement from USFDA, just wanted to give you a small introduction about myself. I'm a regulatory consultant. Actually, my previous experience is about 17 years in the same department in RA. Actually, I had been working for API as well as for formulations. My experience also includes I have worked for companies like Dr. Reddy's, Cipla, and then Pfizer, etc. So today it's a shorter video in which I'll be just briefing you about the stability requirements from USFDA requirements, what all is required actually, how they look for it, and just we will understand what do you mean by stability studies. Okay, so most of them are very much new to this field and new to this topic. So just wanted to tell about the stability studies. It's nothing but a capacity of a drug or product to remain within established specification of identity, quality, purity in a specific period of time, or the capacity of a capability of a particular formulation in a specific container to remain within the particular chemical, microbiological, therapeutically and toxicological specifications. I hope you got it, but again, I just wanted to explain in detail. Like you must be knowing about the API in which an active moiety is there. So we just wanted to check whether that active moiety is stable at what point of time. So that is a thing we check the stability. Unless until we check the stability, we will not be able to know at what point of time your drug is active, at what point of time your moiety will be active. Okay. If the moiety is active up to so particular that time, and that so that we can give a retest period and a shelf life of the particular product can be defined. So this is that's why we do stability studies. Okay, so USP defines stability of pharmaceutical product as extent to which a product retains within a specified limit and throughout its period of storage, and based on this we can give the shelf life of that particular product. Okay. Next, we have the major factors which are just affecting the stability is particle size. Okay. Then pH, additives, and molecular binding and diffusion of a drug and excipients. Particle size, especially, is for suspension and emulsion of the drugs and all. So to determine maximum, why we are doing this exercise? We are doing the stability just to determine the expiration date, shelf life of a product, to provide a better storage condition, because we must have seen so many products they are not good at particular temperature. They have we need to maintain specific storage condition for all the drugs. So that's what we need to take care about the storage conditions also. Now next, we need to determine the packing components, how it is packed, so that you need to prolong the stability life of the active substance, to gather information during pre-formulation stage to produce a stable product. The primary factors affecting stability are pH, temperature, moisture, humidity, light, storage, and oxygen. So all these things we need to take care when we are doing stability studies. Now, what do you mean by retest date? Okay, so many people are there who are unaware about this. What do you mean by retest period and what do you mean by retest date? The date after which samples of the drug substance should be examined to ensure that the material is still in compliance with the specification and thus suitable for use in the manufacture of a given drug product. So at what point of time the drug is intact, or just as I said, the moiety should be in an active state, to that point we need to check. So to check this, we have different programs designed by USFDA. Okay, actually there is a guideline which is ICH guideline, which USFDA strongly believes that whatever you have to do, you have to follow these guidelines. I'll tell you later about the guideline also. Retest period is now we will understand what is retest period. The period of time during which the drug substance is extended to to remain within its specification and therefore can be used in the manufacture of a given product, provided that the drug substance has been stored under the defined conditions. So this is the two different cases, how we decide the shelf life of a drug and how we can give a, date of expiration. You must have seen on the tablets and the capsules or any other products, the expiry date is given. So based on these studies, the expiry date is designed and then only we can give the expiry date of the any of the product. Now to do so, we have a different studies. You know, these are long-term stability studies, accelerated stability studies. These studies are carried out at a different temperatures and to know the stability of the product. Long-term is carried out generally for 5 years, okay? We have a different period. If you can see the guidelines in which it has been very clearly given that 3 months, 6 months, 12 months and so on. An accelerated stability studies is a smaller stability studies in which you can get a short-term period. Okay, that is also given in the guideline. At what duration you need to check for an accelerated, at what duration you have to check for a long-term. Okay, there is a complete guideline which is called an ICH guideline on stability studies, which if you go as per that, US FDA will blankly follow those terms and conditions only given in those guidelines. Okay, so these are the long-term stability studies. According to WHO, long-term stability studies during and beyond expected shelf life under storage conditions in the intended market. Now, these are the recommended conditions for long-term stability storage conditions, and this temperature and humidity, you need to maintain that 60 plus or minus 5, okay? So these are the conditions you need to take care when you're going for these long-term stability studies as well as for accelerated stability studies. Now, again, coming to accelerated stability studies, you have to see that it is maintained up to 30 plus or minus, okay? After 6 months, the accelerated stability studies is done for 6 months. Okay, and when you are doing for storage conditions also, then you have to take care about all these things. How much is a humidity you have to take care, and how much is a temperature you have to maintain. All these things you need to take care during carrying out this stability studies for long term as well as for accelerated. Now, coming to our training details, we also have designed so many other departments, like overall view of the industrial training is done at our end. We have a different departments on which we are giving in-depth training also. And if you want a short-term training, it has been designed in such a way that you will get an overview of all the departments, like if it is a QA, if it is a QC, if it is a RA or analytical, R&D, production, warehouse, or microbiology. Okay, if you want to go in depth, like if you want to go in depth for QA, yes, you will be having all the knowledge about GMP requirements, you will be having a knowledge about audits, you will be having knowledge about complaints, how to handle complaints, and everything is given, right? All the trainings, whatever we have designed, is online as well as offline. You can go in our description box and you can see the details, what all the topics are included in that. And coming to QC, yes, this also we have online as well as offline. QC, we have all short videos on each and every instrumentations, like even the sophisticated instrumentation like HPLC, GC, and everything has been designed in a such a way that you don't feel like you are doing online. If it is as good as doing offline, okay, it has been explained in that detail. Okay, coming to RA again, even in RA, myself, I'm taking for APIs as well as for formulations. Both the training programs are running, in which we will be guiding you in a right from the scratch, what you have to do, how you have to prepare a technical package, how you have to prepare a DMF. Okay, the persons who are working in RA department, we will train you, in such a way that it looks like you are working from last 1 year in the same department. So we are giving in that much detailed training session for RA also. Now, we also, these three departments are practical, like apart from analytical, R&D, production, warehouse and microbiology. These are all theoretical trainings have been given, and you will also have an in-depth knowledge about all these different departments. And then you can also have an idea about what to do, where to select your career. If you are not interested in QA, suppose, then only you can, you know, it's not like that you have to go in QA once you have decided. You can select your career based on these studies, and you will also have a knowledge about each and every department. Then only you can decide your career. So you can enroll whenever like you feel like. It is online as well as offline, as I said. So that is done by Sai Pharma Consultants. They are conducting all sorts of training sessions all over India. Wherever you are, doesn't matter. You can, you know, join in and then you can get started with it. Thank you so much. Thanks a lot for your patience.